Hi everyone, I'm Hanna and today I'm going to talk through the seeds I'm sowing in March. For reference, my allotment is outside Oxford in the UK. We have oceanic temperate climate here with mild winters and cool summers. My last frost date is in mid-May. So there's still time to sow all the seeds I spoke about in my February What to Sow Now video. I really only started by mid-February and all those seeds can be sown in March too. Some things you want to get in sooner rather than later though is broad beans and garlic. Garlic specifically will need a cold snap to encourage it to divide into cloves, otherwise you'll just end up with those little one kind of clove garlic bulbs. And no one wants that. So let's dive into the March seeds. So March is the month I start sowing peas for pods. In February I sowed peas for shoots, but March it's for pods. So I have six different varieties. One super tall alderman pea, and it is really, really fat, big pods. It is a very tall heirloom variety, and I have saved my own seed, so I hope it will grow well. Otherwise I have the old packet as well, but I'm hoping my self-saved seed will be the better ones. I have a dwarf pea that I've saved as well. This is a Hurst Green Shaft, and it is the sweetest pea I have ever had. It's so good. It's just a shame that it's a dwarf one, so you don't get those really tall bushy peas, you know, sorry, you don't get the really tall impressive peas, I should say, like the alderman. But if I chose between the two for flavor, it would be the Hurst Green Shaft. And then I have another Oregon Sugar Pod Monch 2 pea, and that one did well for me. It was one of the earliest to crop, and that's why I'm growing it again. However, I am trying the Golden Sweet Yellow Podded Monch 2 pea as well. So it's Golden Monch 2 peas, and I suppose that they're just going to be beautiful. Then I have a Sugar Magnolia snap pea, so that's the purple podded pea with green peas inside. I'm going to give it a go. Is it just hype? I don't know. We'll see what they taste like. I'm really excited for the magenta flowers and the deep purple pods. And the last one is a semi-dwarf pea called Rosa Krona. So it's an heirloom variety from Sweden, apparently. But to me, Rosa Krona sounds more Danish. And I am Swedish, and I've never heard of it before. But it is a beautiful one with red and pink flowers. So we'll see what they look like, and apparently very tasty as well. And semi-dwarf, you know, not my favorite, but if it's pretty, I'll grow it. Next thing, radishes. Radishes are great to sow up for me up until the end of March. Otherwise, they just get eaten alive. So I get as many sowings as I can now every 2 weeks in February, March. And the ones I'm growing, French breakfast, which is my favorite. And then I have a mystery mix, which is a mix of colors, which is just fun, isn't it? You never know what you're gonna get. I'm also growing some herbs. I sowed some of these already in February, but again, I want a succession sow. So I've got coriander, two types of coriander, parsley and dill. And I've also got Hukatai black mint, a pungent herb used in Peru with flavor partway between coriander and mint. So I wanted to give that a go. So we'll see. And now March is the best time to sow these really long and slow crops, which is celery and celeriac. So I have three types of celery to grow, which is full white, it's a self-blanching type, which I grew last year with mixed success. Cutting celery, which is maybe more appropriate for my climate here. And then I have a red celery. So we'll see which one of these does well. I don't have access to water readily on my plot, so I can't really water these thirsty plants enough. I also have two celeriac. One is monarch, which I grew last year, and I got some tasty roots from it, but maybe not as big as I would want. So I have another giant Prague improved celeriac, and I'll give them both a try. We'll see if one is better than the other. We'll see. So with these seeds specifically, it's very important they germinate in the light, so don't cover these seeds. I have a how to grow celery and celeriac video, and I will put that in here. I direct sowed some carrots in February, Amsterdam forcing, and I'm gonna wait with the rest of my carrots until maybe the last week of March, possibly the first week of April. But what I am gonna direct sow this month is parsnips. This is white gem, and I do have a new packet of seeds, but I can't find it right now. But these are the ones I grew last year. Parsnips, like carrot seeds, have a short shelf life, so it's best to buy fresh each season, especially with parsnips, because they can be a bit tricky to germinate anyway. The trick with them is to make a drill, water the drill, put the seeds in, put more in than you might think you want, and then cover them up and cover them with fleece, and then leave them. They might not germinate for 4 weeks. Keep it moist in dry weather, and hopefully you'll see some germination. If not, you can always sow again in April or in May. So depending on where you are, March is the time to start sowing tomatoes. I have 2 greenhouses this year. I will also grow tomatoes in my back garden and also out in the beds on the plot. There is a difference between sowing dates for tomatoes you want to grow inside a greenhouse and in a very protected, sheltered space like my back garden, and tomatoes you're just growing out on the beds. So the ones that you plant out in the beds, you can't plant out until the last frost date has passed, which is mid-May. So you don't want to end up sowing them too early, to the point where they outgrow your indoor space, so you have to keep them safe until that date. So by mid-March, which is the earliest I'm going to try, and I am going to try to wait until end of March to sow my first tomatoes, are the ones that will grow in my greenhouses and in my back garden. So I have a little selection here, and these are all my yellows and oranges, because I thought these are the ones I'm going to grow undercover, but I think I have space for more, so I have to go through all my tomatoes and choose which ones to start early, and all the other ones will start later. So we'll see. I have a lot of tomato seeds, so I think I need to narrow down what I'm growing, basically. Doesn't everyone? But yes, mid-March is the earliest I will start my tomatoes, and there is no harm in waiting a bit longer. And by the end of the month, melons. I have a lot of packets of melons here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different types, because I have never managed to grow them successfully, and this will be my 4th year trying. I have more greenhouse space this year, and I will also try to build a little mini polytunnel with some see-through plastic that I have acquired, and I will manage. So I'm gonna start them end of March, and I'm gonna sacrifice some valuable indoor space for them, and I'm gonna really, really, really give it a go this year. So these are all the seeds I'm sowing in March. Let me know if there's anything I've forgotten. Please say no. And let me know what you're sowing in March. If you want to know more what I get up to on a weekly basis on my allotment, I am running a weekly vlog project this year called The Allotment Year. So you can check that out on my channel or in the suggested playlist.